These days we hear a lot about net zero energy buildings or energy efficient buildings. We hope you could explain those terms for us a bit in details.
Sure. A popular goal for green building is achieving net zero energy when your building is energy efficient and generates enough energy on site to equal its annual energy needs. Net zero energy buildings are highly energy efficient and will use renewable technology throughout a year to produce as much energy as they consume from the grid. Buildings have a significant impact on energy use and the environment. Commercial and residential buildings use almost 40% of the primary energy and 70% of electricity in the US.
Interesting. So, what is a net zero energy building?
Calibrating expectations is a foundation for success in any net zero energy building projects. In the broadest sense, a net zero energy building is a residential or commercial building with greatly reduced energy needs. In such a building, efficiency gains enable the balance of energy needs to be supplied with renewable energy technologies. But this broad definition leaves plenty of room for interpretation.
So, tell us how we could achieve the same understanding of this matter.
To improve clarity, the National Renewable Energy Laboratory has created two foundational references. There are four net zero energy building definitions: net zero site energy, net zero source energy, net zero energy costs, net zero energy emissions.
How would you explain net zero site energy?
Site energy refers to the energy consumed and generated at a site, regardless of where or how that energy originated. In a net zero site energy building, for every unit of energy the building consumes over a year, it must generate a unit of energy.
I see. How about net zero source energy?
Source energy is the primary energy needed to extract and deliver energy to a site, including the energy that may be wasted in the process of generation, transmission and distribution.
Okay. How will you define net zero energy cost?
Net zero energy cost is perhaps the simplest metric to use. It means that the building has an energy utility bill of $0 over the course of a year. In some cases, building owners or operators may take advantage of selling renewable energy credits from on-site renewable generation.
All right. And lastly, net zero energy emissions.
A net zero energy emissions building either uses no energy, which results in emissions, or offsets the emissions by exporting emissions-free energy.
But does a net zero energy building need to be connected to the electric grid, or not anymore?
Good question. Most net zero energy buildings are still connected to the electric grid, allowing for the electricity produced from traditional energy sources to be used when renewable energy generation cannot meet the building's energy load. When, conversely, on-site energy generation exceeds the building energy requirements, the surplus energy should be exported back to the utility grid, where allowed by law. The excess energy production offsets later periods of excess demand, resulting in a net energy consumption of zero. Due to current technology and cost limitations of energy storage, grid connection is usually necessary to enable the net zero energy balance.
All right. To my understanding, the main purpose of net zero energy subject is how to be efficient in energy consumption.
Exactly. Regardless of the definition or metric used for a net zero energy building, minimizing the energy use through efficient building design should be a fundamental design criterion and the highest priority of all projects. Energy efficiency is generally the most cost-effective strategy with the highest return on investment, and maximizing efficiency opportunities before developing renewable energy plans will minimize the cost of the renewable energy projects needed.
Could you please name few of energy efficiency measures?
Sure. Energy efficiency measures include design strategies and features that reduce the demand side load, such as high performance envelopes, air barrier systems, daylighting, sun control and shading devices, careful selection of windows and glazing, passive solar heating, natural ventilation, and water conservation.
Are these just applicable to new projects or limited to just residential buildings?
Net zero energy building principles can be applied to most types of projects, including residential, industrial, and commercial in both new construction and existing buildings.
Perfect, Emma. Let me thank you for sharing your expertise with us. Thanks for watching and hope to see you next time.